Hello and welcome to the Military and Monetary YouTube channel. I'm currently on my way to my brother's place because today we will have an East German coffee break. You're welcome to join us. What are we gonna do today? Are you excited?
Not really, but we'll see.
I'm really glad that you want to join me because, well, the main reason is the fact that I don't drink coffee. And it's not very realistic to make a video where you try coffee if you don't know how it should taste. So it's great that you want to join me. However, I will of course try it as well. And I have also found a package of East German tea. So, let's go through the things we're gonna try. What is this? Well, this is East German Jell-O. Aprikosengeschmack. And here we have the expiration date. 1985. Exciting, isn't it?
Yes. Jell-O isn't a favorite, but we'll see.
And you love fruit flavor, don't you?
Yes, very much so.
Not. We don't have to open that one, because when I bought them, I got four of them. So we have already prepared this one. Yes. Götterspeise. Mm-hmm. So, let's go on with the coffee. This is Rondo Kaffee. This was a very classic coffee brand in East Germany. Made by VEB Kaffee Halle. And the price was 8 mark and 75 Finnish. And we also have an... what do you call it? Expiry date?
Expiration date.
Expiration date. In April 1989, close to the fall of the Berlin Wall. So I thought we should start opening this one.
So
coffee was very expensive in East Germany, mainly because... Oh, I'm interested in seeing what it looks like. I'll talk more later. And there we have the coffee beans. You want to pour a few of them? As I said, I don't drink coffee. So what do you think about the... Do they smell good?
I'm in no way a coffee expert, but they smell albeit a bit old. They smell like coffee beans, I guess, so...
Give me a few.
Yeah.
They smell a little bit dry, a little dusty, but it still smells like coffee.
Yeah.
Interesting to try. I must say it's in a remarkable good condition.
Yeah.
89, 99, 2009. I mean, it's 30 plus years old.
So, that will be interesting.
Yeah. Okay, let's go on with the tea. Teehaus, Indische Mischung. Do we have a maker on the side? VEB Café und Tee. Let's open that one as well.
Let's see. Yeah.
I'm not sure when this tea was made, but I guess somewhere in the 1980s. go. East German tea.
It smells like a regular tea bag, I think.
It does. I'm having a hard time believing that this would taste bad in any way. Maybe a bit dry, maybe not as...
It says Kaffee though. Not sure if that's the maker or...
Kaffee und Tee.
Right.
Yeah.
There you have instructions.
Oh, instructions as well. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, as I said, coffee in East Germany was very expensive because importing things from the rest of the world was kind of difficult for a country like East Germany. And in the 1970s, they had a large coffee crisis, which resulted in the fact that they had to buy a lot of coffee from the West, which cost the East German state a lot of money. And one way to get through this crisis was to giving money and experience and tools to the country of Vietnam. East Germany and Vietnam had really close relationships, of course. They were both socialist countries. And this is the main reason why Vietnam is growing coffee today. And of course, in return for this money and tool and expertise, they had the opportunity to buy cheap coffee. But still, coffee was very, very expensive. Do you want to show the coffee package again?
Sure.
As you can see, you have the price there, almost 9 marks. And for example, a cigarette package during this time would cost somewhere around 1.5 mark, 2 marks. So if you compare it to the prices today, the coffee was very expensive. Well, enough talking. Let's make some coffee out of this.
Yeah.
So, the table is set in a suitable way for an East German coffee break. And here comes the coffee. So, I guess we have everything.
Yep.
And here we have the East German Götterspeise, which is practically yellow. You want to just move it around a bit so we can get the effect. There you go.
Testy characteristic wobble.
Yeah. Do you want to take a piece of that one first? It was really hard to get it out of the bowl, so we had to cut a piece of it.
It seems to be hard to get it here as well. There.
There you go. So I thought maybe you would like to start,
mm-hmm.
And then we can just switch the camera around. And your first impression is?
It tastes almost nothing, to be honest. It has that fruity, some kind of fruity flavor.
I mean, it's...
But it almost tastes nothing.
It's practically 40 years old, so I guess the flavors in it aren't what they are supposed to be. Well, and these Germans normally eat this type of yellow with vanilla sauce as well. I didn't find any East German vanilla sauce powder, but I guess we can live without it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm thinking the coffee.
Mm-hmm.
And it would be interesting if you try it first.
Mm. we realized when the coffee was brewing that it basically smelled old, much like that, what do you call it? That old uniform smell.
You know,
the moth thingy that you use.
You mean it smells like my old uniform collection?
Yeah, exactly. It smells a bit like coffee, but it doesn't seem to have the same aroma as coffee usually do. But
I do collect East German uniforms. And if you want to see some of it, follow me on Instagram. Link down below. So, let's try.
Yeah.
And the first impression is?
It basically tastes just like it smells.
It
tastes old as well. I think it air must have gotten into this bag because I think it lost most of its aroma. It has a faint taste of coffee basically, but it smells mostly old and dusty.
I see. I'll try it as well. But do you want to go on with the tea first?
Yeah.
I'm guessing the tea will be practically the same.
Yeah, it smells much better.
And he's spitting it out.
it tastes like regular tea.
Okay.
That wasn't bad at all. It tastes a bit old, but it tastes like regular tea.
The smell of the tea, I must say, really smells like tea.
Yeah.
I agree with you. The smell of the coffee isn't really the smell of coffee.
No.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
It was what you could expect. Let's switch the camera around and I'm gonna have a try. Okay, so it's my turn.
My brother is a bit more used to eating these old things, so I think he'll be a bit more used to this, basically, and not spit it out like I did.
You're talking about the East German bread in a can.
Yeah, exactly.
And the cigarettes as well.
Yeah.
Check the links down below if you want to watch it. And one more important thing, because what do we want for trying all of this and letting people watch it on YouTube? Well, subscribe to the channel, give a thumbs up, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Yummy. It really doesn't taste anything.
No.
It's like cold jelly.
Yeah. With a faint taste of fruit.
It really. I'm gonna spit it out as well.
Yeah.
One minute. Because it smells more fruity than it tastes.
Very much so.
And I'm having a hard time believing it would be better with vanilla sauce.
No.
No.
That's a nightmare.
Okay. Let's continue with the coffee. And I, as I said, don't drink coffee. I've never had a full cup of coffee in my entire life. In one way, it smells a little bit like tea.
Yeah, maybe so.
There's a faint touch of tea.
Yeah.
Interesting. Well, of course, it tastes coffee. Like coffee.
Yeah, a bit.
But a very strange coffee taste.
Yeah.
It's bitter. Not the best I've had.
It must be because the coffee beans have been exposed to air throughout
really
the years.
Really dry, really dusty.
Yeah.
Okay, let's continue with the tea. But actually, it smells good. I don't have any problems with this.
No, me neither. It tastes like tea, basically.
No need to spit it out, really. I mean, it's a little bit dry. The flavors aren't, you know, top notch.
No.
But it still tastes like tea.
Yeah.
Like that low price tea.
Yeah, regular Earl Grey, basically.
Not bad. So, what can we say about all of this? This one?
Not good at all.
The time has not been kind to this one.
No.
The coffee?
Bad, but not terrible, basically.
If there was a war raging and you haven't had coffee in 6 months and you find a package of Rondo coffee, like that would ever happen, but if it would, or a drawer, would you drink it?
Oh yeah, of course.
It's good enough
to
last in war.
Yes.
That's a good review. And the tea, I must say, no problem.
No.
This was interesting, and I'm glad you wanted to join me. Well, that's it, I suppose.
That's the coffee break.
That's the East German coffee break. If you have any ideas about what you should try later on, just leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching.